to Fred Achando Analysis, ladies and gentlemen. If you are watching the channel for the first time, allow me to request you with the greatest humility to subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to click the notification bell and like our videos. The latest political development in Kenya is becoming very interesting by the day. The Raila Ruto saga is taking a new twist, and I've got a feeling that Raila Odinga has cornered William Ruto, and he has cornered the international community, because Raila Odinga indicated that it is the USA, Britain, and a member of the EU states which combined and connived to rob him of his victory. Now it is the same nations that he accused of robbing him of his victory that is now throwing back the ball to come back, open the server and audit, because he believes he won the last elections by 8 million votes. And I feel this is really tempting. Raila is really tempting the international community. When they thought that Raila would lead his people to go to State House for a bloodshed so that they can accuse him, Raila is taking a low profile. Raila is holding consultative meetings in all the 47 counties so that they can be charged, so that no one will say that he has been left out. Now I want us to look very briefly at the options that the UN has, because Raila said that he's inviting the Commonwealth and the United Nations to come and open this server. I want us to look at the option, because the request that Raila is giving is one that is a near impossibility. Before we do this, there are a few questions that we need to ask. Number one, apart from the declaration at Jacaranda grounds that the Commonwealth and UN should come and open the server, have they written an official letter inviting them to do so? Because we want to understand that he was not just talking to the masses, but he has written a letter. We've got a team of lawyers. In fact, the top brass of Azimio Brigade is full of lawyers. The deputy Azimio leader, Martha Karua, is a lawyer. Kalonzo Musyoka is a lawyer. We've got people like Otunda Mwelo, Orengo. We've got people like Mutula Kilonzo Jr. We've got a team of lawyers in Azimio. Makau Mutua, you can name them. And so if they put their heads together and do a letter to the United Nations, it will be better than just making the populist declarations in a rally. So I believe they have done so. Now what are the options that the UN has now that they've been requested? I'm asking this because the permanent members of the Security Council at the United Nations are the very, very victims that Raila is accusing of conniving to rob him of this victory. They include the USA, the United Kingdom, France, China, and Russia. Those are the permanent members of the United Nations Security Council. So from where I sit, these are the options that they have. They might decide, because number one, I have a feeling that they will discuss this. They will meet, the five of them, to discuss whether to grant this request or to decline. How do you think they will vote? If it is true that the USA and the United Kingdom are victims of election malpractices in Kenya, they will vote no. And so we will have three members: Russia, France, and China. France will vote and side with the USA and the United Kingdom. Russia will vote yes, because of the obvious reasons. China might abstain, because China is very interested in the economic investment that they have made in Africa and in Kenya. So they might abstain. So if they decide to vote, it will be a no, and they will tell Kenya that the United Nations have considered all the options and they have declined the request to come open and audit this server. So that is option number one. But where does this leave our mission? Raila declared that after the 2 weeks, if the United Nations or the Commonwealth come, if they don't come, then they will take the law in their own hands. Well, this would mean that they might even decide to go and try to evict Kenya Ruto from State House. Ideally, to pick their avails maintained that that would be a bloody affair. Some people are telling me, Achando, let it be. Let those who are dying die so that those who remain will remain in peace. Of course, I'm one person who believes in peace, and I don't advocate for death and altercation that will lead to innocent lives being lost. But sometimes revolutions demand that some people will have casualties. So if the United Nations does not come in very fast, if they decline this request, then you know the country is going to be turned into turmoil. Because Raila will say they have already indicated that they don't recognize the legitimacy of President William Ruto and Rigathi Gachagua and the entire staff that have been appointed by William Ruto. So the first option is that they can decline using their numbers at the Security Council. Number two, they can decide to buy time. Within this period, because they might write back to Raila telling him that we are weighing the options, let us prepare. 2 weeks is such a very short period. Give us 1 month or 2 months. During this time, they can decide to interfere with the server. Technology emanated from these people. We are just copying them. If Jose Camargo managed to get into our servers, when did you hear that Jose Camargo is dead? He was doing that when William Ruto was still the deputy president. Now that he's got the sword, Jose Camargo can come unnoticed and he can still interfere with that server. If they do that and they are satisfied that they have done everything, because when they interfere with this server, they will do it in such a way that there will be justification of Ruto's win. And so they will now say, Raila, we are ready, so you can come and audit the server. And they will call all the ICT departments from Raila's side, from the United Nations side, pretending that they are neutral, and from the Kenya Kwanza side. And it will be in the front glare of the camera. So they will be auditing one by one. And then by the end of it, they will be clear that William Ruto won fair and square. And where does this leave Raila Odinga? Raila will walk away very humiliated, because people will see him as one who does not accept election results, and that will be the end of Raila Odinga. I don't think if that happens, he can contest again. The Zimbabwe supporters will be very disappointed, and they will say it has been a joke all along. And the Kenya Kwanza team will walk away a happy man, and they will start in their usual manner. In fact, I don't know what will happen on every Sunday when they go to church. They will really, really give Raila a lot of headache. Number three, they can force a handshake between William Ruto and Raila Odinga. Raila Odinga has declared, not once, not twice, that he is not interested in the handshake. The Kenya Kwanza team has accused Raila of a man who is only interfering with William Ruto so that they can have an opportunity to sit down for a handshake like they did with Mwai Kibaki and with Uhuru Kenyatta. But one thing that they're not telling us is that in 2007, even William Ruto himself was there, and William Ruto declared that Raila Odinga had won. So they are putting it as if Raila was defeated and then he requested for a handshake. It is the international community, the very many people, the USA. You remember Condoleezza Rice, who came here and said that there must be real power sharing? They are the people. They gave Mwai Kibaki that win. Because I remember the then US ambassador to Kenya, Mr. Ranabaga, congratulated Mwai Kibaki in spite of all the things that happened in the full glare of camera when the ODM leaders like Orengo were chased from KCC, and Kivutu remained there alone to announce the results. So now they want to pretend that they have forgotten. They say that Raila Odinga went for that handshake. So the USA, the Britain, can force a handshake. I don't know where this will be the help, because he has said he does not want it. He has defied all the orders. If they decide to force it, what will happen? Wakianza kukaza macho na wasema lazima. I don't know what can happen if they decide to force them. The last one, they can decide that now push has come to shove. When the country is burning and there's new supporters have decided that we want our win and nothing less. Sometimes we can accept this, open the servers the way it is so that we can see the winner. If it is William Ruto who legitimately won the August polls, then he continues. And again, Raila walks away a humiliated man. And if William Ruto did not win, and it is true that Raila has got 8 million votes, then Raila has given his victory. Or they will bring another story that we can now go for a rerun because it is the IEBC who declared Ruto, he did declare himself. That will invite another constitutional debate whether William Ruto, a man who has got the sword, can just relinquish power and give it to a person who had declared as an opposition leader. So these are things that we are still waiting to see. But I've got a feeling that the international community will not accept. Because if they know, and I'm saying if they know that they interfered with the elections, do you think they can accept to open the servers? Because that will be shooting themselves in the foot. And that will, you know, will prove Raila right. Like he has always been. Raila, you know, there's a joke in Kenya that if Raila tells you that you're expecting a child, don't question how, just start buying the diapers and the nayets. So he has always been seen as a man who does not lie. When he says something, he has got his secrets, and there are people who leak secrets for him. So he will prove them wrong. So ladies and gentlemen, we want to see after the 2 weeks have elapsed, I don't know what the next move for Raila Amolo Odinga. But Martha Karua was saying that ulizaliwa siku moja na utaenda siku moja, usiwe mwoga. These statements really speak a lot. And you might imagine where the country is headed to. I don't know what you think, but from where I sit, these are the options that the UN and the Commonwealth have. Please give me any other if you think that forgotten. Tell me, let us engage in the comment section. Again, if you're watching for the first time, kindly subscribe and don't forget to click the notification bell so that whenever we do a video like this, YouTube will automatically notify you. Like our videos, and again, thanks for watching.